all this? This is every single bag of crisps I have eaten over the month of eating crisps only. When I'd started, I did have a few rules. It had to be proper sliced vegetable of something. I couldn't have any of that extruded, formed potato or corn snack or anything like that, because they tend to have more salt in and this, that and the other. So there's no Pringles, there's no Monster Munch, there's no Discos, there's no anything like that. There's not like that. Now, but sliced potato, so, well, potato, beetroot, I think, because that's what was in these, sliced beetroot, parsnip, and carrot. That was the rule that I had. I found there's been flavours that I have gone off. There's flavours that I have really enjoyed eating. And I've even found new brands of crisps whilst I've been doing this. Let's have a run through! I think the one flavour, this is going to be so bizarre, the one flavour I couldn't manage to have done without whilst doing the whole month of Crispatarianism is actually salt and shake and shake your own. Shake your own. Salt your own. Salt your own from Lidl and obviously the salt and shake by Smith's, but Walker's, isn't it? Because you didn't have to add the salt. You can just leave the salt out if you wanted to. Leaving them as plain crisps. And it was so satisfying to eat just plain crisps because you knew you wasn't putting excess salt in you. Which was nice. There's other plain ones as well, actually. I've got some Tyrrell's plain crisps as well in here somewhere. All the multi-pack bags are 25 gram, with the exception of salt and shake, which was 24 gram. But when I've been filling out my chart, I've just been saying it's been 25 gram. Because it was just easier just to do that. I've probably eaten maybe a bag less altogether because of I did buy so many of these salt and shake ones. The big, massive bags of crisps here, you know, let's see if I can find one quickly. Was it day 10? No. Which one? I can't flaming find one now. Where's a bigger bag? Oh, there we go. The Tesco ham with spiced cola glaze. They were actually really good. This massive bag here, what I would do is I'd weigh out 25 grams at a time into a bowl or a small plate. And because it's crisps, you can't just wolf them down as quick as you'd expect. I found that you had to take your time eating them because otherwise I got a mouth-related injury. Now, there was a few that I had over the month and I don't think I've mentioned it at all yet. I'd say about five times, I ate some crisps and it stabbed the roof of my mouth or stabbed that really delicate part of your mouth between your gum and your teeth. You know that, and it really hurts. I did it just 2 days ago, actually, with some Seabrook's crisps. No offence to Seabrook crisps. I love Seabrook crisps. It was just the one that came to my head. I even did it once with a McCoy's, so there you are. And I love McCoy's crisps as well. These. Now, these were just in 25 gram bags, and I still had to weigh it out. And these were a bit of a faff, because I had to keep resealing them up and then going back to them and weighing out 25 grams. And they're actually surprisingly high in saturated fat. In fact, these are the most. And by looking at it and seeing the name brown bag and blah, 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 blah. And I bought so many of them off of Amazon as well. Oh, and I've got this and smoky bacon. It's the flavours that I'm fed up of. I got so sick of eating these. This is the only flavour. Even smoky bacon I've got fed up of. But this one I've got completely fed up of eating it. Now, it might sound a bit bizarre, I mean, and look a bit bizarre because there's an entire day where I just ate these crisps, but that's because I wanted to get rid of them. I remember day 14 very well. I thought, I cannot stand to eat these anymore. They have got to go. And clearly I did, because there's none left on day 15. Day 15 is a good one to bring up because Taste of Game crisps, these are also ones that I got off of Amazon. These are amazing. I would definitely buy these again. They're very expensive for crisps. I've forgotten the price of them. feel free to go back to day 15 and watch the advert at the beginning of the video. These taste of the game crisps. Oh, what this? That one was Grouse, the purple bag. I'm dropping the salt on the floor. And what was the other one? Duck. And the other one was Pheasant. I think it was three flavours. What was the fourth flavours? I don't know. I would definitely recommend that you give Taste of the Game a go. Fantastic crisps. Absolutely delicious. These are the little blue salt sachets. Sachets. Out of the salt your own. Odd. Salt and shake. I never once cut into these. Whenever I had the salt and shake, or the salt your own, I always took the salt out and I never put open the salt and pour it in. Other flavours I've got fed up of? None. I don't think, no. I was very, very happy with all the rest of the flavours. As it put me off crisps. We'll find that right out at the end of this video. Well, I've got a bit of a cliffhanger, haven't I? Anything else that I've enjoyed that I've discovered? Yeah, just in the UK, we have such a vast amount of crisps. It's insane. This is not an exhaustive amount of flavours or brands. I've obviously been picking ones that I have liked and finding out new ones. I think the most popular brand here... Oh, that's something else I haven't found out yet. We can find that out at the end of the video as well, because I've not even looked into that. Is it Walkers I've eaten the most of? Is it McCoy's? Seabrook's? Lidl? We don't know. Lidl is, coincidentally, the only own brand that I've eaten because I live very close to a Lidl. Oh, there might be one co-op bag in here. Might be one or two bags of co-ops, actually. But yeah, this is fun. I feel fun. Way back on day one, I actually found this a really good way to keep me going. And when I started off, when I told people on YouTube and when I told people in person, oh, I'm doing a diet of only crisps, I'm being a Crispatarian, I'm doing Crispatarianism, I'm only eating crisps. Generally, the replies was, the salt, the saturated fat, the calories. It's been fun. I've lost weight doing it. There'll be pictures of all this at the end so you can see what I've had every day if you can read my writing, because obviously I didn't start doing this in best or anything. I was just scribbling it down. For the month of November, I have eaten in crisps 36,969.475 calories. The sun today, it's really sunny. It's the 1st of December. Which works out as 1,232 calories, 0.3158, a day. Which is significantly less than the 2,500 I'm meant to be getting, you know, as a big butch bloke. You know, that's how many calories a man needs. It's not sent me insane at all, I've always been insane. 292 bags. And I feel fine, absolutely fine. When I first started doing all this, in the first couple of days, I had this oily flavour sort of taste in my mouth from the sunflower oil. That sort of went away. I have been drinking normal drinks. I've not cut down on anything intentionally, but what I found is fizzy drinks were significantly unpalatable. I found that normally I could easily go through a 2-litre bottle of Coke Zero, or lemonade, or cherryade, or anything in a few hours. I love fizzy drinks. But when you mix fizzy drinks with the crisps I've been having, I found that I'd have this really, really weird taste in my mouth, and it was almost like a burning sensation at the same time. And it also made me more hungry that I'd want more crisps, because that battle between the salt and the fizzy drinks were just going on incessantly. I found that I was drinking a lot more tea. A lot more tea. A bit more coffee than usual. Now, I don't really like hot drinks, but I found I was drinking more tea, more milk, and more fruit juice. I was drinking fruit juice more than ever, because obviously I was more aware that I wasn't getting the nutrients from anywhere else. Now, my diet is atrocious. I put on 2 stone because of lockdown 1 and 2. And I've lost over 1 stone now by eating unhealthily. But if you gain weight unhealthily, I think you can lose it unhealthily. I know that's probably not what any dietitians will tell you, but they can all do one. As far as I'm concerned, I was drinking plenty of fruit juice. I've drank more fruit juice in this month alone than I've ever had before, I think, because the flavour of the fruit juices didn't make me want to have even more crisps. I found the fruit juices was almost like a dessert, if that makes any sense. But I suppose it does, because you can have fruit as a dessert, can't you? It's a boring dessert, but it's a dessert. Let's go back to more statistics. More statistics? Yeah. Is it going to be a surprise? But the brand I eat the most of is Walkers. Is that a surprise? And when I say Walkers, that does include Smith's, because it's owned by Walkers. The money I spent is still going into Walkers' pockets. 100 bag of Walkers, 47 bags of Lidl branded crisps, which is by far and away the biggest supermarket owned brand, just because Lidl is so close. And you know what? It tasted really good, especially the Lidl Lights, the crinkle ones. They're called Lidl Lights. I ate most of them on the last couple of days, actually. Where are they? Where am I up to? Where's day 30 gone? It's right at the top. Day 29, was it? Yeah. These are amazing. There's a ready salted one and a cheese and onion one. And the cheese and onion one is there. These taste really good. Making sure I don't mix this up. They're really good. And there really was lower in saturated fat as well, with bizarrely the brown bag being the highest in saturated fat. Now, I don't know why that is. Maybe a particular one of the vegetables absorbs more oil than the rest of them. I don't know the reason. I'm just making that clear. I don't want to get sued or something by a brown bag. Difficult getting the peg back on this one. And the next one down is McCoy's. I ate 29 bags worth of McCoy's crisps. Now let's get in. Oh no, I won't get into favourite flavours yet. I'll continue the list down. Then it was Seabrook crisps at 27, so just slightly below McCoy's. 24 bags worth of brown bag. I'm surprised it's that high, but the grammage on this I had to weigh out all the time, because these are 40 gram bags. I weighed them out at 25 or 50 grams at a time and ate them. And that was the only flavour that made me feel sick, actually. Well, that's a bit of a hint of best and worst flavours, isn't it? Where that one's going. Salty Dog, 12 bags worth. They're the ones that I got from TK Maxx. A great place to go for bizarre brands and bizarre flavours of crisps. I like TK Maxx's food section. Co-op, I get 12 bags worth. And at first sight, I can't really see any Co-op. I've just gone straight to it. I did go straight to it. But yeah, Co-op. Back there. And then it was a celebration of brands beginning with T. Tyrrell's crisps. I loved the plain Tyrrell's. 11 bags of that. 11 of Taylor's crisps. Now, Taylor, I am not too sure where that came from. Do you know, for the life of me, I cannot remember eating them crisps from Taylor's. Taylor, I don't know where they are. I don't know where they are in all of this. Taste of the Game. Oh, they were amazing. 10 bags worth of those I've eaten. Then it was Tato at 5. I think it's in there, because I remember the yellowy sort of bag. Yeah, Tato, which is an Irish brand. I randomly got... Where did I get them from? I think I got them from Tesco. And then Tesco at 4. There we go. 292 bags worth of crisps. And I lost 1 stone. Yeah! Woo! I'm really delighted I've lost 1 stone. Best and worst flavours. This is all the flavours of crisps separated out. There's 26 different flavours. These are the Mad Hatter sort of ones, which I've not been able to put into categories. The Tyrrell's Black Truffle and Sea Salt, they were nice. The Ham and Spiced Cola Glaze, they were really nice. I remember these. Now, I got them from TK Maxx, look. Beef and horseradish were nice, I think. Can't remember the flavour of them as much. Turkey and stuffing flavour. You'd expect that to taste like chicken. And it was, but because of the stuffing, it didn't taste really chicken-y like chicken-flavoured crisps. Cheddar cheese and truffle. Now, you'd expect to put that in the stack of cheese and onion, but I didn't because it's got truffle flavour in there. So I did separate that one out. I can't remember the flavour of that one as much. And, oh, this is the ham and whole grain mustard flavour. These were really nice. I was really happy with them, weren't I? To the point that I'd completely forgotten I'd already done a review of them, but I did like those also about 4 years ago. These are the Taste of the Game flavours. It looks as if I've lost a pack. It looks as if I've accidentally thrown a crisp packet away. It was bound to happen at some point, wasn't it? Or I might just find it. Maybe it got stuck in another bag here. But Wild Boar and Apple. All these Taste of the Game ones was amazing. Wild Duck. Smoked Pheasant. And Grouse with Wineberry. Or Winberry, whatever it's called. Fantastic. And the very recent Walker's Sausage Roll flavour. They were alright, yeah. Not too bad. Don't think I'd buy them again, though. That's all the crazy flavours out the way. Now let's get back onto the normal flavours. Well, you might see that it's a clear indication of winners of the flavours I've eaten the most of. This massive stack here is clearly the winner. This is technically plain. It was Salt Your Own from Lidl, Salt and Shake by Walker's, or there was Tyrrell's Naked Unsalted flavour. The plain flavour was just a really good flavour to munch on when I didn't want an aftertaste of anything. These are lovely. Doesn't really matter who makes plain crisps, but this Salt Your Own salt and shake and plain flavour things are a really good idea just to reduce on salt. This is the only stack that I'm having trouble keeping stacked. The next winner is probably going to be Ready Salted. Look at this sea of red, it's just like red and white. And no matter who makes Ready Salted crisps, it always seems to be a red colour. Walker's, Smith's, even before it was taken over by Walker's, McCoy's, and Seabrook, I keep putting an S at the end, all red. But yeah. And then the next flavour, I don't know why I've stacked that on there. That's just a ridiculous game of Jenga, isn't it? The next flavour I've eaten the most of, I think, is very close between cheese and onion and prawn cocktail. Because grammage-wise, these bigger bags, you see. Cheese and onion in three different coloured bags. I do forget about Seabrook having yellow. And even the potato crisps was in yellow. So somewhere between 1945 and 1956, the brands thought, we're going to have yellow as cheese and onion. I don't know about McCoy's. I've forgotten how long McCoy's have been going. And then other brands have just copied off each other, such as Lidl copied off Walker's. This was the most annoying flavour because I kept mixing it up with the salt and vinegar because of the amount of blue in cheese and onion crisp packets. Prawn cocktail, always pink, whether it's Walker's or Seabrook's, I think most brands as well. See, prawn cocktail was such a great flavour as a sweet because it is quite a sweet flavour. Because it's not actually a fish flavour if you're not aware of prawn cocktail. It's more of the sauce, the prawn cocktail sauce flavour. So that's a really good flavour to have. Stinks though. Oh, that's definitely one of the smellier flavours. That's definitely one of the smelly flavours next to the fish and chips flavour from Seabrook as well. And the next down flavour is by default, but, you know, it's... I'm not really included in the most eaten flavour because I didn't even like these in the end, did I? But, yeah, I seem to have eaten a lot of them, but only because I ordered so many in the box, because that's the minimum order. If they'd have been in a pack of 4 or 6, I would have probably just had that, and then that was it. So, that's that. Salt and vinegar is one of my least favourite flavours. It's not a flavour that I'd run out and buy a multi-pack of, but I have eaten salt and vinegar due to the fact it's in so many multi-packs, obviously, back in the day. I think it was always blue for salt and vinegar, Seabrooks, McCoy's, and it was only Walkers that booked the trend on that. It's funny, out of all these flavours, I still seem to have gravitated towards the original flavours. You know, the standard, proper standard flavours. Plain, very salted, cheese and onion, prawn cocktail, and even salt and vinegar. I'm surprised I've eaten that many salt and vinegar, to be honest with you. Moving down the list now, there's like a significant drop in the flavours selected. That was just because it was a multi-pack for the Marmite flavour. I went off smoky bacon very quickly. I thought I'd actually eaten more smoky bacon than this, but I haven't. I must have eaten more smoky bacon than this. Yeah, I have eaten more smoky bacon than that. Where's all the Walker's ones gone? I must have mixed them up because it's really easy to do because some of these colours look really similar. Where's all the rest of the smoky bacon gone? In... Oh no, they are there. The Walkers is there. Is the Walkers there? Yeah, it is. Feels like I've had more than that. Has it gone? Have I not mixed it up now? I'll find it if I've mixed it up. I don't think I have. That's all the grilled steak flavour. That's a great flavour by McCoy's. But obviously there's there's my favourite one. Oh, I love it so much. Then there is Worcester sauce. Or Worcestershire sauce. I like to say Worcester sauce, and I like to put emphasis on the W and the R. I like to go Worcester sauce. You can call it Worcestershire sauce if you like, but internationally I think it's easier to say Worcester. Yes. And the already salted falling everywhere now. And bacon. That beef and onion is a flavour that keeps coming and going through Walkers. I actually like beef and onion crisps, but can I really get it from Walkers now? There's this Walker Sensations Thai Sweet Chilli, and I think everyone could eat way more bags than that, but I just didn't. I was quite impressed with myself, actually. This is the only flavour, I think, that I did hold back from because I knew that I would eat significantly more of it. I could go through massive bags of these in one sitting. Same as I probably would with this one. That's all the flavours I've spoken about. Yeah, there's the chicken. I've eaten more chicken than I thought. Chicken flavoured crisps than I thought I would. But I'm quite perplexed why I haven't got more smoky bacon because I went right off them. I think it's because I've eaten so many McCoy's ones, maybe. I'm really surprised there's not more. Maybe I threw the bags away accidentally for smoky bacon. Because they're not here. They're not here. Oh well. That's the flavours that I've eaten the most of. Plain, salted, cheese and onion, prawn cocktail, salt and vinegar. They're your proper standard ones. But there's so many more flavours than this. In Selfridges, I've already done a review of them ages ago. There was a caviar flavoured crisps. There is a saffron flavoured crisp. This isn't even close to how many flavours of crisps there is in the UK. Is it the same anywhere else in the world? I do understand from several news stories, though, that we do eat the most crisps in the UK. We're quite the crisp lover, apparently. I don't see the attraction myself. And that is sarcasm. Oh, sarcasm machine. That's a really useful invention. Depending on how I've edited all this together, there were some flavours that were very off-putting after a very few bags. And there were some flavours that I have absolutely enjoyed and wished there were more available.
Let's start at the bottom, shall we?
It's no surprise, at the bottom, I am putting brown bag. Because they don't taste of anything other than salt. And they were quite greasy as well. These ones left the most aftertaste in my mouth. I didn't find them enjoyable. Now, there is other flavours of these. This is just the plain veggie ones. And it was beetroot, parsnip and carrot. They just made me feel sick. I didn't enjoy eating them as much at all. I got bored of them very quickly. And because there were so many of them that I ordered from Amazon, it's the flavour that I regretted buying the most of. I really don't want brown bag to get all... because, yes, they do other flavours, but I just got bored of this particular one and it sort of affected the rest of the month for me. I was sick of that. Next worst was tato. The tato ones was... these ones, and it's an Irish brand. And the blurb on the back was a bit annoying for this one as well, because it's a castle cooked since 1956. And on the big outer bag, it was like, oh, we take, oh, just say on this as well. Set deep in Ulster's countryside is Tato Castle, where Tato have been making some of the world's best loves, crisps and snacks since 1956. Using the best local ingredients, Mr. Tato selects the finest selectively grown spuds, gently cooking them until crisp and golden. Finally, in a special part of Tato Castle, our crisps are given their unique secret and flavour, ensuring you get irresistible crisps every time. They were not irresistible. I bought one pack, one multi-pack, and that was enough. And the secret flavour is Flavour Enhancer. Quite clearly says it in the ingredients, because none of the rest of the crisps I've had it. I found that when I get these crisps, I found that they were really oversalted, because obviously there's more than one kind of salt in these crisps. Well, there is in all crisps, probably, because you've got the natural salts in the potato, you got this and the bit of the starchiness from that. Then you got the added salt, unless it was the salt and shake or salt you own. And then in this one, you got the monosodium glutamate. I'm not against MSG. I know loads of people are like, woo, MSG, ooh, additives, ooh, blah, blah, blah. I'm not. I mean, no, there's no mass people dying, is there, of eating additives such as MSG. It's just a kind of salt. There is a lot of overhype about additives and stuff. One of the best things I've seen on YouTube and Facebook and Twitter and whatever is where someone's listed out all the separate parts of an apple and they wound up a non-vaxxer saying, would you put this in your body? And the anti-vaxxer was like, no, I would not. And it's like, well, we've actually just listed everything that is in an apple. There is a lot of overhype. The media is a lot to blame for it as well. They love to overhype something, don't they? You know, ooh, you shouldn't eat MSG. Ooh, you shouldn't eat aspartame. Or aspartame, as some people like to pronounce it. Ooh, you shouldn't eat this, you shouldn't eat that. Oh, shut up. Yes. So they're my two worst flavours. Potato, cheese and onion, because they were just incredibly salty. It tasted like a really old-fashioned crisp. It was just so oversalted. And brown bag. Tasted salty and greasy. Didn't enjoy that at all. Every other crisp was pretty much, as you'd expect, standard. You know, somewhere in between okay and nice and enjoyable, obviously, because I managed to stick to it for the entire month. And I didn't exhaust all the flavours. And there were so many flavours of crisp in the UK, I've already said, unless it didn't make the original edit. Favourite flavours. Favourite flavours is tough because it's a toss-up between Taste of Game and McCoy's Thai sweet chicken, whatever it is, whichever way around it is. Now, I suppose if you split that into two categories of affordable and everyday, mid-market, obviously McCoy's would win because it's more accessible, really, but not as accessible as it should be, McCoy's. The Thai sweet chicken, can I get one to hand? Because I did eat quite a lot of them. Of all the McCoy's that I did eat, that was the one I ate the most of. I can't see it right now. That was definitely the best. Taste of the Game is quite an expensive crisp. It worked out over £1 something a bag. But oh, that was good. All the flavours of that as well. really, Taste of the Game should win because I've liked all the flavours. There were four different flavours, and all of them were just absolutely amazing. They tasted really unique, and they didn't taste just as if they'd put more salt in, or just a bit more whatever flavouring to make the crisps good. And have I just found the Thai sweet chicken? I have. This one, for whatever reason, McCoy's does not sell in bigger bags. And you can only really find it in multi-packs. I did see it when we randomly went into the Tesco that they were still selling it as part of the meal deal, which made it quite expensive. But these are amazing. This flavour is amazing. Still smells good. Thai sweet chicken is by far and away the best McCoy's flavoured crisp. It's a ruffled crisp as well. It's a crinkle cut crisp. Really satisfying to eat. Which brings me to another point. Is that, oh, look, I did eat it. Oh, that must have been a good day. Look, a Taste of the Game and Thai sweet chicken. Oh, what a flavour day that was. Oh, and I even had some Marmite Walkers on that day as well. They're quite good. Just because it's just a different flavour. I'm salivating already, which might sound mad that I've finished a month of crisps and I'm still salivating over crisps. They're really nice. Other things it helped me with as well is portion control, obviously. I am really bad at portion control. I cannot open a bag of oven chips, chicken Kievs, chicken nuggets, anything like that. Or even proper fresh stuff, like a block of cheese. I find it really difficult to put some back. I really do, and that might sound like really piggish, and it probably is. But I just love the taste of food. And one of the problems with fighting obesity and this, that, and the other, it isn't fighting getting people who are obese, overweight, and fat to move more. It's trying to, in some way, stop them enjoying food so much. Because food that is more healthily and this, that, and the other doesn't taste as good as the rubbish. Now, I know people are saying, yeah, that's because the rubbish food's full. No, that is not the point. And this is why I hate Jamie Oliver so much. It's because they're always saying, oh, eating healthily is cheap. It is not. This crisp challenge that I have done has cost, if it weren't for the Taste of the Game crisps, which are the most expensive, I've saved so much money. I mean, you can pick up a 6-pack of crisps for a quid, sometimes cheaper. And you're thinking, well, fruit and veg can't compete with that. I would love to be able to afford, I'm salivating over strawberries now, strawberries and blueberries, you know. I love cauliflower cheese. All right, it's got to be covered in cheese for it to be enjoyable, but I love cauliflower. I do like veg, I do like fruit, but it's so expensive and it doesn't last. And as well, the supermarkets don't really offer the full range of the fruit and veg in the sense of the variety of the fruit. I've banged on about it so many times on my previous videos. Strawberries, there are loads of different varieties of strawberries. Apples, there are so many different varieties of apples, but when you go into a supermarket, you're lucky if you get, what, 5 different type of apples? Like Golden Delicious, Cox's, Granny Smith, a cooking apple. I had to throw that one in. And another one that you regularly see in a supermarket, Gala. And that's pretty much all I can think of right now. And one of the red ones that the name of it I forget off the top of my head. You see what I mean? And strawberries, it's usually always El Santa, or what they've really got into now is farmers have started trademarking their own names, but they're usually always grown from El Santa. Big red strawberries look amazing, no flavour, or as tough as leather, because they need to last the transportation process of getting into the supermarkets. That's why it's always better to go straight to a farm, or go to a farm shop if you're lucky enough to live near one. But crisps, there was just, there must be like 100 different flavours. And they're cheap. They're in you can portion control with crisps. What's helped me is writing down everything. Because that way I could say, ooh, I'm eating too many of that flavour, or I'm eating too many crisps. With the chart that I made, going through, I could see that 13 crisps I'd had that day, and that day, and that day, and that day, and that day. 5 days, I'd had 13 crisps. And that is a lot. And I can look at that and go, that's too much. Even though I'm only eating, what, 1,000... even though I'm only eating 1,700 or 1,600 calories, that's a lot of crisps, isn't it? 13 bags. But because I was only eating only crisps, it's significant. It feels significantly less. But by doing this chart and tracking my weight, calories and bags, it shows you what you've eaten. Do I recommend this? I've already sort of answered this question in a previous video this month. There's going to be loads of dietitians, doctors, nurses, surgeons, every man and his dog saying, "Ooh, no, you shouldn't do that." In realistic terms, there are people getting married. There are people who want to make sure they can fit into a certain suit or costume. Actors, singers, dancers. Maybe they need to be a certain weight because that is the life and world we live in. For a very short amount of time, I think a month is a long period of time, but definitely I'm not going to not recommend it. If you need to control your weight or if you really need to make a change, for me personally, oh, I hate saying that, for me personally. What? I'm not going to say for me somebody else, am I? What a stupid phrase to say. For me, it's a good start to think, do you know what? I need to continue eating fewer calories and moving more. I didn't do any extra exercise than I normally would when I was on my Crispatarian month. And I didn't do any work, hardly, because we're on lockdown. And that's a contributing factor of why I've probably done so well, is because if I was at work, running around, working a very well-known theatre, hopefully I'll be reopening soon, it's a very big place. A lot of running up and down, helping customers find the seats, getting them in the building, getting them out the building, selling ice cream. It's a lot of legwork, a lot of stairs. There's no lift. If I was doing that at the same time, I would have probably lost significantly more weight, but I would have eaten probably a lot more crisps for the energy. I think I've covered everything now. I know this is a really long video, and it's been a really long series. I know that a lot of people have got bored of the series, and of indeed my channel, from doing this. But do you know what? To be brutally honest, I didn't do it all for you. I did it for me. And by documenting it on YouTube, it also helped me, and with the support that I did get from my subscribers, thank you very much, that with your support and doing this chat, it was made extremely more possible to do it. I followed it through. I've lasted the entire month. I showed to myself that I could stick to something for a month. I've learned that I should definitely eat more fruit and veg when it's affordable. It's also shown me as well how much waste there is. Let's go into how much there is. Look. Look at all that. That is a lot of non-recyclable foil packet of crisps. Now there is TerraCycle, where you can send all this away to get recycled. But do you know what? I can't be bothered, and most people can't. On the back of some of the bags, it says, consult your council on further information. Who's going to do that? Who calls the council on purpose and goes, oh, I've got a crisp packet. What's the best way to recycle it? Getting through to your council's a right pain in the backside anyway, isn't it? I was talking the amount of waste, but really, look, there's a half a bag, half a bin liner full of crisp packets, and that's uncompressed. Have I actually contributed more or less to the litter in the world? I don't know. Thank you all. Thank you all so much for sticking with me for the past month of November of Crispatarianism.
Would you do it? And do you think you could do it?
Because, like I say, it's not something I probably should legally recommend. But at the same time, personally, I'm not going to unrecommend it. If you've got something or somewhere you need to be and something you need to wear and you need to lose a stone, bearing in mind I've been drinking whatever I could feel what I wanted. If I was hungry, I had a bag of crisps. I was surprisingly filled up by crisps. I think it's because of the motion of eating rather than something like a burger where you can take one bite, three bites, swallow and it's gone. A bag of crisp, you've got to make sure it's in a complete mulch, aren't you? So it doesn't, like, stick in your throat and give you, like, deep lacerations of your esophagus. I think that's enough. I think I've covered everything. Favourite flavours, how many bags of crisps I've eaten, which brands I've eaten. I've shown you my graph. I've shown you my chart. I have shown you my weight. I have shown you everything, I think. If there's anything else you want to know, because I've got everything written down and I can probably find it out for you, just let me know in the comment section. Salt-wise, I've eaten significantly less salt every single day. I think it's meant to be 6 grams. Out of all these months, there was 2 days where I think I ate 4 grams of salt. I ate no more than the recommended daily allowance. Saturated fat, right down. Carbs, I think carbs might be high, but not a lot. I'm going now. Thanks for watching. Bell me. Bye. Although some days were tough, no, I'm not bored of crisps.